While other teens still sleep, Dawn Loggins is in the hallways, classrooms, and bathrooms of Burns High School, where she's a senior and janitor. Each morning, she cleans the rooms where she'll later return to learn.
But that myself should be the root and father of many kings.
Then come 7 hours of advanced placement classes and honors classes. Then 2 more hours of dumping trash and picking up after her classmates.
I don't mind cleaning because if you have to wade through trash to get to your desk, you're not going to have an environment that encourages learning.
Finally, she tackles homework till 2 a.m. Besides being dedicated, school officials knew something else about Dawn. Life at home wasn't exactly perfect. There were the eviction notices. The family moved a lot. Burns High was Dawn's fourth school since eighth grade. When she asked about candles, her boss realized the team was living in a house with no electricity.
She came to me and she said, I need something to be able to do my homework by. And I said, okay, we'll get you some candles. We'll take care of that.
There was also no water.
We'd get water jugs and fill them up at the park, like using the spigots in the bathroom. And we'd use that to like flush the toilet and cook with and things like that.
It got worse. Last year, when Dawn tried calling home from summer school in Raleigh, the phone was disconnected. Her mother and stepfather had moved again, this time leaving her behind.
I never expected my parents to just, like, leave.
You were homeless.
Yes.
Dawn would crash a few days on a couch here or a night or two on the floor there, but still cleaning and still keeping up her grades.
I think what motivates me is the fact that when I was younger, I was able to look at all the bad choices, at the neglect and the drug abuse. And I was not going to have to ask myself, am I going to buy food this month or am I going to pay rent?
What makes this story so amazing isn't just Dawn Loggins. It's what the school, it's what the community did. You see, the moment it was realized that Dawn was abandoned and homeless, she should have been turned over to the state, the Department of Social Services. But that didn't happen. That didn't happen on purpose.
We kind of took it upon ourselves to become her village.
So teachers and staffers made sure she was clothed and fed and had a place to live.
The people are nice, though. We have good people in Lawndale. Yeah, it's a nice community.
And it didn't end there. That same village was now out to get her to college, and not just any college, Harvard. History teacher Larry Gardner wrote the recommendation letter and simply told Dawn's story.
This young lady has, unlike most of us, known hunger. She's known abuse and neglect. She's known homelessness and filth. Yet she's risen above it all to become such an outstanding young lady.
Months passed. Thick acceptance letters arrived from state schools, but nothing from Cambridge. Then one day, a thin envelope with a Harvard seal arrived.
I'm delighted to report that the admissions committee has asked me to inform you that you will be admitted to the Harvard College class of 2016.
I didn't jump up and down, and I didn't cry or anything like that. Like, it did get the largest reaction out of any of my acceptance letters. I sort of did this, like...
Not only was she accepted, but her tuition and housing would be paid for.
I mean, you kind of teared up because this is a young lady who... When I first met her and had her brother in class, they were living in a home without electricity, without running water. They were showering at a local park.
She's not let those circumstances hold her back, and that's going to kind of, she's going to be that symbol that you're able to achieve, meet your milestones, meet your goals, no matter what.
And that's how Dawn Loggins went from homeless to Harvard. Martin Savage, CNN, Lawndale, North Carolina.